Dear students, something when we are missing in writing the compounds, then in vain after writing the paper. Many students are discussing on the functional groups and compounds, but they don't know how to remember the different functional groups, which is not only required for the 10th class, but also they are extremely important for the 11th and 12th class. Today's topic is how to remember functional groups for 10th, 11th and 12th class. You are knowing that carbon and oxygen, when they are joined together, there is formation of the single bond. So carbon oxygen single bond is important for the three different functional groups. So these are important for the alcohol, they are important for the phenol, they are important for the ether. So alcohol is nothing but containing of the OH group, phenol is again OH group, ether is OR group. So this carbon and oxygen as a single bond can remember you alcohol, phenol and ether. When you go apart from that, you can remember carbon oxygen double bond, which is important for the aldehyde, which is important for the ketone, which is important for the carboxylic acid, because aldehyde containing carbon oxygen double bond along with hydrogen, ketone containing carbon double bond with oxygen along with the two alkyl groups from left and right side, carboxylic acid containing carbon double bond oxygen along with OH group. So in this way you can remember alcohol, alkyl group along with the hydroxyl group, phenol, phenyl group along with the hydroxyl group, ether, alkyl group along with the alkoxy group, whereas aldehyde, carbonyl group C double bond O along with the hydrogen and alkyl group, ketone, alkyl group, carbonyl group and alkyl group or aryl group, then carboxylic acid, alkyl or aryl group along with the carbonyl group and hydroxyl group. It is a combination of carbonyl group and hydroxyl group that is called carboxylic acid. So in this way, alcohol, phenol, ether, aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid, these are the six different functional groups and the compounds that should be remembered always for the 10th, 11th and 12th class. Apart from this, how to remember the other functional groups? Now let us take the example of the carboxylic acid group. Now carboxylic acid group is like this, C double bond O OH. I can remove OH by X. So by removing OH by X, this is called as the acid chloride group. Acid chloride group. After that, I can remove this X also by NH2 group. Amide group is called acid amide group. I can remove this NH2 group by OR, C double bond O, OR. This is ester group is there, COOR, ester group is there. So apart from the alcohol, phenol, ether, aldehyde, ketone, carboxylic acid, three more derivatives we have studied. First derivative, that is acid chloride, COX, X may be ClBri, then CONH2, that is acid amide group, then COOR, ester group. So 6 plus 3, 9 functional groups are over. What will be the 10th functional group? In the 10th functional group, I can join two carboxylic group. I can join these two carboxylic group. When I join these two carboxylic group, the water molecule is removed. When water molecule is removed, then there is formation of this type of compound, C double bond O, C double bond O, and oxygen is attached to the two carbonyl groups. This is anhydride group. This is called as anhydride group. The famous anhydride group is acetic anhydride CH3 C double bond O CH3 C double bond O attached with the O, that is anhydride group. This is the 10th number of functional group. So apart from these 10 functional groups, 5 functional groups are also there. That is very simple. 11th functional group is amine group. This is NH2 amine. This is 1 degree amine. I can write NH. This is 2 degree amine. Then N only. This is 3 degree amine. So in this way, 11th functional group is amine group. Then SO3H. This is sulfonyl group, 12th subfunctional group. Then apart from this, nitrile group is there. Nitrile group or cyanide group is there. Apart from this, isocyanide group is there. Apart from this, carbon-carbon double bond, alkene group is there. Apart from this, carbon-carbon triple bond, this is alkyne group is there. So, 11th number amine group is there. 1 degree amine or primary amine, 2 degree amine, 3 degree amine. Apart from that, sulfonyl group is there, 12th number, 13th number, cyanide or nitrile group is there, then isocyanide group is there, then carbon-carbon double bond alkene functional group is there, and lastly carbon-carbon triple bond as a alkyne functional group is there. So in this way, for the 10th, 11th, 12th class, different functional groups are alcohol, phenol, ether, aldehyde, ketone, carboxylic acid, then acid chloride, then acid amide, then ester and anhydride, then amine, then sulfonyl group, then nitrile group, isonitrile group, then alkene group and alkyne group. So in this way, there are 15 functional groups which are very important to making the compounds by adding the alkyl or aryl group with these functional groups for 10th, 11th, 12th class. Dear students, functional groups are those which can change the properties of the whole compound. Therefore, functional groups are very important. And I hope so, you will understand this topic of functional groups, how to remember the functional group, and how we can attach the alkyl or aryl group to this functional group to give the productive compounds which are useful for the study of 10th, 11th, 12th.